Do subscribe to IKIDA channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
So the question has been asked that at 290 Kelvin, the heat of combustion of glucose at constant pressure was found to be -2,723.78 kilojoule. So we have to calculate the heat of combustion of glucose at constant volume. So in this case, the temperature is given as 290 Kelvin, while this value, that is -2,723.78 kilojoule, is for the heat of combustion of glucose at constant volume. So what is the heat of combustion of glucose or heat of combustion at constant pressure? And one is also that we have to calculate the heat of combustion of glucose at constant volume. So let us see what does this term means. So the given data, the heat of combustion at constant pressure is nothing but the delta H itself, that is the enthalpy itself, which is given as -2,723.78 kilojoule. That could be written in the terms of joule also. So therefore this will be -2,723.78 × 10⁻³ joules. And regarding that, they have also provided us the temperature. The temperature is T, which is 290 Kelvin. And they have said that during the heat of combustion of glucose at constant pressure, we have to calculate what will be the heat of combustion of glucose at constant volume. So the first thing that we are going to do is we are going to calculate that what would be the reaction for the heat of for the combustion of the glucose. So let us see. So for glucose, we know that C6H12O6 will require 6 times of oxygen so as to obtain 6 times of carbon dioxide plus 6 times of H2O. In this case, what happens is every state which is present in this case is of, as we could say, that this glucose which is of solid, again oxygen which is of a gaseous state, again carbon dioxide is again of gaseous state, while H2O in this case also appears to be in gaseous state. So by this thing we could easily calculate what would be the change in number of moles. So the change in number of moles would be, it is represented by delta N, which is the change, it is nothing but the difference between the number of moles of gases minus the number of moles of gases in products minus the number of moles of gas in reactants. So the number of moles of gas in products minus the number of moles of gas in, so in this case what we are going to do is the total number of moles of gases in product side minus the total number of moles of gases in reactant side. So in this case we can easily observe that this 6 moles of gas and 6 moles of gas of carbon dioxide and 6 moles of gas of that is H2O, this both will be combined to make 12 moles, while that of the total number of reactants which are present in gaseous state is only the oxygen which is present on the reactant side. So that is 6. So therefore 12 minus 6 is nothing but 6. So therefore the value of delta N is nothing but 6 itself. So we know that if delta H is being asked, is been given, and we have to calculate the heat of combustion of glucose at constant volume, which means we have to calculate the delta U. So this is what we have to calculate, because QV, that is heat of combustion at constant volume, is nothing but delta U itself. So we have a formula, that is delta H is equals to delta U minus delta NRT. Or we could also say that delta U is equals to delta H plus delta NRT, but we could write it in this formula also. So therefore the value of delta H that they have been given to us is, we have calculated as minus 2723.78 into 10 raised to 3. In this, we have to calculate the value of delta u minus, in this case, delta n, which was calculated to be 6. The value of r is nothing but 8.314, and the value of T, that is temperature, is nothing but 290. So let us see what is the answer that we could get. So we have got a value of minus 2723.78 into 10 raised to 3, which is equals to delta U minus of 14466.36. So in this case, we could easily calculate what will be the value of delta U. So I will shift this value over here. So this so therefore what I could get is minus 2723.78 into 10 raised to 3. This will be now converted into plus 14466.36. Let us see what is the answer that we could get. So we have got a value of, that is, minus 2703.6. This could be written as in the format of minus 2709.313 kilojoule. So this is the value of the delta U, or we could say as the heat of combustion of a gas at constant volume for a glucose, during combustion of glucose. So this is how we have calculated the value of delta U, and delta H was already provided to us, but in different format. So thank you, friends, for watching this video. I hope you have got an idea that how to calculate this kind of numerical. So share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeda channel. Thank you so much.